First, we need to see how an individual demand curve is derived. Suppose you have this demand schedule that follows the law of demand, that as price increases, quantity demand decreases. And these are some hypothetical combinations taken. Okay, these are no real data. Following the law of demand, some hypothetical data is there. Now, at price 5, quantity demanded 10 units. At price 10, as price increases to 10, the quantity demanded decreases to 8 units. And as price increases to 15, the quantity demanded increases to 5. So as price increases, the quantity demand gradually decreases. We get these points when we map this graph, table in graph. We get these points. When you join these points, the locus of the combinations, when you join these points, you get what is known as a downward sloping demand curve. When you join these points, you get an individual demand curve. Next, we come to the derivation of market demand curve from given demand schedules. Suppose, now see, in the market there are so many individuals, so we cannot take so many individuals to put it into theory. So what we do, we assume that there are only two individuals comprising the market. We consider that in the market there are only two individuals to simplify. Whatever happens for two individuals, it can be generalized for so many individuals. The process remains same. So we assume that there are two individuals comprising the market. So the demand schedule for two individuals are given, where at different prices the demand for A and the demand by B are given. Now, how do we get the market demand? So at price 5, consumer A demands 10 units and consumer B demands 8 units. So the market demand is 18 units, 10 plus 8. At price 10, the demand by B is 8 units and the demand by B is 5 units. So the market demand is 8 plus 5, 13 units, and so on. So we get the market demand schedule. We get the market demand schedule by adding up the individual demands at various prices. Now, with respect to individual A's demand schedule, you get the demand curve for individual A, which is given by DA. With respect to individual B's demand curve, you get demand schedule, you get the demand curve for individual B. So you get the demand curve for individual B as DB, TB. Now, the market demand curve, how it is obtained? The market demand curve is obtained by the lateral or horizontal summation of individual demand curves. The market demand curve DMDM is obtained by laterally summing up when the price was 5 by A consumer A, the commodity demanded was 10, by consumer B it was by 8, so 18 units demanded in the market at price rupees 5. Similarly for rupees 10, the market demand is 13, and similarly for at price rupees 15, the market demand is 9. So the demand curves are horizontally summed up or laterally summed up, and we get the market demand curve given by DMDM. This is the way you derive the market demand curve from given demand schedules. We take a simple assumption that there are two individuals comprising the market. Okay, so this is the way. Please note it down. You have to write it exactly I have written, and this be very careful. This lateral and horizontal summation is a very important keyword. Don't miss it while writing. Thank you.